Welcome to Grace TV or Grace Teaching Videos.
You are watching one of the Grace TV ministries that was born out of lockdown.
Here we serve bite-sized spiritual meals.
Or you can call it Bible study online.
So wherever you are in the world,
before having anything else,
Soul Food First!
This is Pastor Dean Padayhag. Welcome to Soul Food. Today we will begin another series on the dispensational place of fasting in the scriptures. Now, like baptism and speaking in tongues, which we are going to study in the coming days, fasting is also one of the most discussed and one of the most divisive topics, especially among the evangelicals and charismatic movements out there. Although many of them agree to the practice of fasting, but they usually disagree as to the length, the purpose, and the procedure of fasting. Many people practice fasting without understanding the reason and the purpose of it. Most of the time, they practice fasting because of the tradition, to which Colossians chapter 2 verse 8 gives us a warning. It says, "Beware lest anyone cheat you through philosophy and empty deceit, according to the tradition of men, according to the basic principles of the world, and not according to Christ." Now, as we approach this subject, we should not only be biblical, but also dispensational. It means that we are going to ask if it is in the Bible, and also ask if it is for our time to practice, observe, and obey. Now, we need to be real Berean Bible believers as we are going to talk about this subject. In Acts chapter 17, verses 10 and 11, we have the characteristics of these Berean people. It says, "Then the brethren immediately sent Paul and Silas away by night to Berea. When they arrived, they went into the synagogue of the Jews. These were more fair-minded or noble than those in Thessalonica, in that they received the word with all readiness and searched the scriptures daily to find out whether these things were so." So these people in Berea, they were not just hearing and listening and receiving the word, but also they are asking questions, they are searching, they are investigating if what they are hearing indeed are from the scriptures. Equally so, we must also remember the God-given principle of Bible study, and that is rightly dividing the word of truth. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 15 says, "Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth." Having said all these things, let us ask some questions about fasting. What is the meaning and the origin of fasting? When did fasting start? What are the purposes of it? And then, do we need to fast in this present dispensation of grace? I believe these are very important questions that we have to answer as we study this topic about fasting. Let us start with what fasting is not. Number one, it is not intended to just afflict the flesh, but to focus on God. So fasting is not about us and how long we are doing this, but it is about focusing our mind, our heart on the Lord God. It is not to punish flesh, nor hurt oneself, but to have an undivided attention focusing on God. Number two, it is not a dieting method. Fasting was not intended to lose weight, nor detox from any physical toxins, nor cleanse one's physical body, but rather to gain atonement and deeper fellowship with God. Number three, it is not a way to get God to do what we want. It is not a way of twisting God's hands to get our desired blessings and answers of our request and prayers. Number four, it is not a hunger strike. You know, some people, they want something and so they go for fasting. Again, it is not a hunger strike nor an aggressive demonstration of our intention before God. It is not to forcefully get a job, get a spouse, get a car, or having that desired achievements as others ignorantly do. So, what is the meaning of fasting? It is, the word fasting is from the Greek word nistia. It comes from the negative prefix ne or no and is theo, which means to eat. So fasting means not to eat. The origin of fasting, it starts from the Old Testament. It is God's command to fast in the Day of Atonement for the people of Israel. Again, it is for the Day of Atonement and for the people of Israel. And I would like you to understand that, and I'm going to emphasize that. That command about fasting, it is very important command of God to the nation of Israel. And there are also consequences for disobedience of that command. And so let's go to the book of Leviticus chapter 16 verse 29. It says, "This shall be a statute forever for you. In the seventh month, on the 10th day of the month, you shall afflict your souls and do not do work at all, whether a native of your own country or a stranger who dwells among you." And then we have the expounded version in Leviticus chapter 23, verses 26 down to verse 32. We have the elaboration of this command in this passage. It says, "And the Lord God spoke to Moses, saying, also the 10th day of this seventh month shall be a day of atonement. It shall be a holy convocation for you, and you shall afflict your souls and offer an offering made by fire to the Lord." And so there is that afflicting of souls, and we'll talk about this tomorrow. And then there is also that offering made by fire, you know, the sacrificial offering to the Lord. And then verse 28, the Bible says, "And you shall do no work on that same day." So when they do fasting, they should not be working also. "For it is the Day of Atonement, to make atonement for you before the Lord your God." Verse 29 says, "For any person who is not afflicted in soul on that same day shall be cut off from his people," meaning that person is going to die. Verse 30, the Bible says, "And any person who does any work on that same day, that person I will destroy from among his people." Verse 31, "You shall do no manner of work. It shall be a statue forever throughout your generations in all your dwellings." And then lastly, verse 32, "It shall be to you a Sabbath of solemn rest, and you shall afflict your souls on the ninth day on the month at evening. From evening to evening, you shall celebrate your Sabbath." Beloved, these passages here are so rich of information about fasting. And tune in tomorrow as we are going to continually talk about this topic. Fasting, very important information that we have to learn and questions that we are going to answer throughout this study. So tune in tomorrow as we continue with this series. Beloved, thank you very much for watching. Enjoy your soul food.